Welcome back to Colonial Sports Center. My name is Malik Johnson, and with me we have Trevor Young, my good friend. How are you?
Nice to be here. Nice to be on.
Yeah, so you are doing the documentary A New Era for Army Football.
Yeah.
So I guess my first question is, how is it different? You produced Colonial Sports Center my freshman year.
Mm-hmm.
How's it different from what you've done before?
Well, doing a documentary like this, it's episodic. So it is kind of similar to a studio show, but it's also very different. Because with a studio show, I was working with a large group of people. This documentary, I've mainly been working just by myself. So it's been, you know, I've been directing, shooting, editing it, all kind of aspects of it.
So have you had any help from athletics? Like, how much oversight do you have?
I mean, it is an internship through the school, so I do get direct oversight from Becky Schoniker and, you know, Ken Baker, and some of the, even the coaches give me kind of insight into what they think about, you know, the overall product. But as far as the process of making it, it's been mostly me.
How did you end up with the internship?
Well, over the summer, like I said, Becky Schoniker, who is a video coordinator for athletics, she was looking for video workers, student workers, and I came to her with this idea. I had been watching Last Chance U on Netflix and programs like Hard Knocks, and I thought, you know, we should do this for the football team and kind of, you know, detail the story of their entire season, because I think that would be something interesting.
So is that, I guess, what you're trying to emulate when you're doing these documentaries?
Yeah, definitely. Especially the game footage of shows like Last Chance U, I really found, like, interesting, so I wanted to sort of copy their style, but like I said, it's less about, you know, the drama around the players in Last Chance U, and it's more of a positive piece.
Yeah. So you've been following each game as they happen. You had one for training day. Is there anything that you would want to cover behind the scenes?
You know, I think I want to incorporate more behind the scenes stuff into the general episodes. For the Dayton episode, we had, you know, some of the coaches meetings and things like that. And I want to keep incorporating more behind the scenes stuff as the season goes on and as the team gets more comfortable around me. But like, I think just using some of that behind the scenes type footage in the episodes would be something I want to do going forward.
Okay. And would you consider yourself close at all with the team? You've been there a while. You're not exactly a coach or anything.
Yeah, I mean, traveling with the team, staying at the same hotels with them, rooming with some of the guys, you know, I think starting now, the team's starting to get more used to me. Some of the coaches and players are getting used to me being around and, you know, building sort of relationships with those guys. I went to Kennywood with them, which was cool, and got a lot of nice shots from there, too.
So, who's your favorite?
My favorite players, as far as like watching them on the field, I love watching Elijah Jackson and Terrence Stevens run the ball because I think they complement each other really well. And, you know, on special teams, Wanit is, you know, he's just a ball of energy and he's really exciting to film. And, you know, he's sort of like the team morale booster. And, you know, I love watching him play. You know, all those guys, they've all been great to me. They've all been great to, you know, working with me for interviews and stuff. So I love watching all those guys play.
So how much of the football team watch? How much do they tell you about what they think about the documentaries after they come out?
I've gotten feedback from a lot of the coaches specifically will come in and tell me a little bit about what they thought of the video, or, you know, say, nice job, you know, I really like this, I really like that. And some of the players have reached out to me and said, you know, I really appreciate that you're doing this. It's nice to get extra coverage. And, you know, they've all been really positive about the outcome and about the work. Specifically, some of the players I interview, sometimes they don't always watch it, but once they're interviewed, they definitely are watching that episode. So then they'll give me, you know, feedback on that, and it's cool to get positive encouragement going through a project like this.
Okay, so if you could cover one other Army sport the way you did Army football, who would you cover?
I think it would be women's hockey. I absolutely love the sport of women's hockey. I think it's very underappreciated and undercovered here at RMU, and, you know, around the world. And, you know, in the past couple of years, seeing players like Brittany Howard and now J.C. Gebbard and Christian Walsh, it's been like, there's a lot of really good talent there, and they seem to have a really fun environment.
Okay. What's a story that you can tell on Colonial Sports Center that a player, somebody that doesn't have the opportunity to say, what can you say?
Well, I mean, I don't want to say anything that a player wouldn't say. But, you know, generally, there's no, like, big gossip or anything. You know, these guys have been working really, really hard, and I think some of them maybe wouldn't even just tell you that just because of the, you know, the effort and the time that these players and coaches have been putting in. You know, they are 1-5, but I can attest that they have been working extremely hard, you know, even when it was 90 degrees in the summer. And, you know, I think some of them are pretty humble because of the results, but, you know, they've done a lot of work.